Hi, I'm Arthur.
And I'm Vivian.
And we're content creators and writers for Microsoft 365. And today we're going to talk about what's new in June.
Yeah, so this month we're covering updates to Microsoft Cloud App Security, collaboration features in Outlook, and also new company-branded templates in PowerPoint Designer.
With Microsoft 365 security features coming out this month, you'll have new tools to protect your company's data, monitor access, and improve security posture. Need more shadow IT in your organization's security? Whether it's Microsoft Azure, Amazon Web Services, or Google Cloud, discover apps and services running on top of them. In the MCIS portal, select the Discovered Resources tab, and you'll be able to take a look at things like what resources already exist, what users are accessing them, transactions, IP addresses, and how much traffic is being transmitted. Also new, there is an update on Identity Secure Score. To hear more, we wanted to talk to the experts. Let's take a look. With me right now is Jimmy Lin, Product Marketing Manager. Jimmy, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Great, talk to us about Identity Secure Score.
Sure, so Identity Secure Score gives you a great overview of how your identity security posture is doing. And so with Identity Secure Score, you get increased visibility to your security posture, but also recommendations on how to improve it. And so these recommendations are surfaced directly with an Identity Secure Score with guidance and workflows on how to actually implement these recommendations. So the more recommendations you implement, the better your identity security posture becomes and the higher your Identity Secure Score could get.
Great. Now I hear there's also some updates on conditional access. Can you talk to us a little bit about that too?
Yeah, so with conditional access, we're really excited to make it available within Microsoft 365 Business. Conditional access allows you to automate access control decisions for company resources like cloud applications based on a set of conditions you define. So you could set the exact conditions a user needs to meet in order to gain access to a company resource. And so these conditions could be based on a user's sign-in risk, their device compliance, their device platform, or even their network location. So conditional access is a really great way to empower employee productivity while keeping your organization safe and secure.
That's great to hear. Thank you, Jimmy, for your time.
You bet.
Also new this month, we have features to help you meet compliance requirements. Microsoft Teams is introducing information barriers, which help you limit how much information is being shared between users. This is helpful for a company that needs to follow ethical wall requirements or industry regulations, like preventing a day trader from reaching out to a colleague on the marketing team. In short, this just helps you avoid conflicts of interest across Microsoft Teams. For our friends in the EU, Yammer is now offering local data residency to help EU companies meet data residency requirements. This feature is available to all new Office 365 tenants in the EU. In the coming months, Yammer content will now start to appear in e-discovery searches. For Yammer groups connected to Office 365 groups, this will bring advanced security and meet compliance needs. In Office 365, we're also changing the minimum seat requirement for multi-geo capabilities. This will reduce the number of seats from 2,500 to 500. This will help companies address multi-geo capabilities that address regional, industry-specific, and organizational data residency requirements.
Now let's chat about Office updates. New this month is recommended documents. You'll see this feature across your Office desktop apps. They're a curated set of documents to help you find files and get back to work quickly. We're also bringing version history to Office for the web. You can see what changes have been made to a file and go back to an earlier version if you want. These updates are rolling out to PowerPoint on the web first, with Excel and Word coming soon.
With Outlook for iOS, you can now view your most recently used files from SharePoint, iCloud, or any iOS device, like an iPhone. And if you add a link to your file in an email, instead of attaching it as a file, the access permissions set by your organization will automatically match up. This feature is rolling out to iOS users now. We have some exciting new features coming to Outlook and PowerPoint this month. Let's chat with an expert and learn more. I'm here with Richard So. He is a senior product marketing manager with PowerPoint, and he's joined us today to talk about inking in Outlook, as well as new updates to PowerPoint Designer. So, hi, Richard.
Hi.
Let's start with what's new with inking in Outlook.
Sure. The inking technology that you know and love within Office, so in Word, Excel, and PowerPoint, is now coming to Outlook. So what that allows you to do is to easily mark up your emails. Let's say you want to have a picture that you put in there or some sort of a visual mock-up. You can go ahead and annotate directly within Outlook, and then from there, send that off to for approvals or for edits.
That's awesome. And I hear there's some big news coming with templates with PowerPoint Designer.
That's correct, yes. So with PowerPoint Designer, we just announced Designer for Brand and Templates this month. And for that, it allows it to work with a company's own custom templates that they create and allows employees to stay on brand when they're creating and designing their own slide decks. Also as part of that, we're also announcing Designer theme ideas. And what that does, it allows you to easily just insert some text on a slide, and the AI engine will go ahead and pull up some relevant, high quality, beautifully, fully licensed imagery that you could use to help accent and make your presentations pop.
And finally, I hear there's some new feature rolling out that'll take big numbers and just make it easily digestible. Tell me more about that.
Sure. We actually are learning a lot from Bing and using that technology within our other products. So for PowerPoint in particular, when someone enters a large number onto a slide, let's say they're typing out that commercial airplanes fly at about 30,000 feet. What the AI technology will do is then, through Designer, surface up a relative measure and say about the height of Mount Everest. And then for there, you could put that into your slide, and then people, when they're viewing your presentation, will really understand what you're trying to communicate.
That sounds awesome. Thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you. It's great to meet you.
Likewise.
With Microsoft Whiteboard, you can now give collaborators a thumbs up to show you like their content. This feature will be available for Whiteboard in Windows 10 and iOS in the next few weeks. And finally, Azure AD now supports a maximum character length of 256 characters. This will help improve your organization's security by making passwords harder to hack.
And that's all we got for today. If you like the format of today's show, like or subscribe to our channel. And if you have any feedback on things you'd like to see next month, let us know in the comments below.
See you next month.